I'd like now to introduce one of the most exciting new groups with the Motown sound. Ladies and gentlemen, Smokey Robinson and the Miracles. Welcome. Yay!
The way my director, Ernie Sherry, was shooting the group, it looked like there were 100 people in it. You weren't able to see it, were you?
Sometimes when we're on stage, it seems like there are 100 people in it.
Right.
You know, do some wild... You do some very wild things with tambourines. Can you possibly teach Marty Allen and Steve Rossi how to work with those? Maybe they can help out with the group. Come on out, Marty and Steve. This is Smokey Robinson. It's Steve Rossi and Marty Allen. You need this? Okay.
Where are we?
Hi, how are you?
Okay, no, he's going to help you out. He's going to show you how to do some things with tambourines here. Here, hand him in.
Hey.
Oh, first of all, Smokey, if you demonstrate a step and then show them what to do.
Well, okay? I think that it would be more appropriate if one of the guys show them, because I don't know the steps either.
Oh. Hey, you look. Would you like to meet this group, Smokey? Go ahead. Will one of you fellas step down?
Yes. Well, we're going to start the intro, and... You step back with your left foot first.
Yeah.
Then your right foot.
Yeah.
And then you jump. Like so. You turn. Jump. Again. Right.
Good.
And then back around this way.
I got it.
And you change hands on the jab race on the left.
Yeah, would you do it just one?
Yeah.
Do it once.
Yeah, we'll go.
Would you do it
ready?
Once alone?
Yeah, let's do it.
Me?
Yeah,
just do it.
Oh,
it's just so let's take care and go.
Can we see Marty do it once alone, please? Okay. Oh.
Well, why don't you do something?
Hey, Marty, look here. See?
Oh, yeah.
Wait, I got it. Wait, you just throw it, Rick.
No, that's not it, guys. Right. That's not it.
I'll tell you one thing, you ain't gonna get too much in the collection.
I want to hear from Smokey Robinson and the Miracles again with Point Siena.
Forever and a day. Ooh.
I'm going to introduce you all now to a very amazing group of young men, because every record they have made in the last 10 years has gotten in the top 100 bestsellers, and the song they're going to open with has been on the best-selling list for 20 weeks. So welcome Smokey Robinson and the Miracles.
Flying over the island.
We have a lot of young high school students in our audience today, and that accounts for the tremendous reaction when they saw heard me mention
you. Oh, wonderful.
But would you show, this is a style that was once popular, which Alan and I both remember, it's coming back. Would you show your trousers to the audience?
Oh, sure. I'd be happy to.
You see that waistline?
See how high they are?
Yeah.
The high-waisted trousers.
It's the zoot suit, but it's narrow.
Yeah.
Yeah. The narrow
zoot suit.
Yeah. The high waist is coming back here.
Very nice.
That's it.
Thank you. Let's talk.
Sure.
I had a chance to sit you down in here and talk to you at great length. But in addition to singing and having the group, Smokey is also the vice president of Motown Records. And I think you better tell our viewers about Motown. Some of them around the country might not know about it.
Well, Motown Records was actually formed, or started to be formed, in about the latter part of 1958. And we were just local at that time.
In Detroit.
In Detroit.
Motown is Motortown, right?
Yes.
Right.
Yeah.
That's where we got the name from.
Yeah.
City was known for the cars. So we formed it about 1958, and we were local. And about 1959, the latter part, we went national on a record with the Miracles, entitled Way Over There. That was the first national release on Motown label.
That's great.
And now, am I wrong? Isn't it about this? It's the second largest record organization in the country.
Second largest record seller of single records.
Single records.
In the United States.
Well, in the last couple of years, we've been first, Mike.
Really?
Happy to
oh, really?
Mike, for
That's
single
records. That's the best place.
For single releases we have.
But you also write and produce for other Motown acts. Name some of the people that you produce and write for, Smokey.
Well, actually, we have a staff of producers there, Mike, and they all produce for every one of our acts. The Supremes.
Which is pretty big. Aren't they the biggest single girl act?
Yes, they are.
Yeah?
It's now Diana Ross and the Supremes, isn't
right.
it?
Right. Yeah. And the Temptations.
You see why they sell?
We're liable to be here for four more hours if you keep that up.
The Four Tops and Stevie Wonder, Martha and the Vandellas, the Marvelettes, just scores of artists that we
great.
Have now since we've...
Are they all from Detroit?
Well, most of them are making their homes in Detroit now, Alan. They some of them are not originally from Detroit. But most of them make their homes in Detroit now.
You've turned the car town into Music City kind of out there, haven't you?
Yeah, incidentally, Barry Gordy, who is the founder of Motown Records, received a citation from the mayor last year of Detroit for the Small Businessmen's Association. And during his speech, he was saying that he has found that in Detroit, it used to be known for the cars, but now it's known for the records. So we're very happy about that.
Motown is predominantly a Negro organization, isn't it?
Well, predominantly, but we have a very integrated staff there.
That's
we
a
have
great example.
Integrated artist staff and business staff. One of our vice presidents is a white guy who is a very... Yeah, we give everybody a break.
Mike, I got to
How'd he sneak in there?
Gorky, do you mind? How old are you?
27.
Oh. 27.
Vice president.
10 years. 10 years.
You were 17 when they started.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. Well, you weren't vice president when they started.
No, I wasn't. This happened about 4 years ago.
That's nice.
But did you finish high school, Smokey?
Yes, I did.
How about your group?
Everybody did.
And why?
Well, because it's the best thing to do, especially for these times that we're living in now. I recommend this for any artists who are planning to go into show business, any young artists, any young groups, to finish school first, because it's the most important thing right now.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Watch it, you have it too, will you, Smokey?
Nothing.
Smokey Robinson, I heard.
First I have to know, is everybody ready?
Yeah!
A one, a two, you know I'm ready to dance. Lum de lum de la. This is Mickey Smokey, I want you to join in on this sooner or later. You know a cat named Mickey came from out of town. All around, they're doing it right here, right now. In just a matter of a few days, dance became the new teenage craze all over. When the people see him dancing, they began to sing. He's supposed to say, lum-dee-lum-dee-la.
Lum-dee-lum-dee-la.
Right. Well, see this dance to that monkey thing. Wait. Really something to see.
Smokey Robinson and the Miracles have a new single titled If You Can't Want. But we asked him to do one of his old hits. So here now is Smokey and the Miracles.
Thank you.
Here's a group that I love to listen to, but I don't care much about playing poker with them. No, this is a group with plenty of fire, ladies and gentlemen, from Motown, and you all know about that sound. Here is Smokey Robinson and the Miracles.
Thank you very much.
A good group. And what's so enjoyable to me is that not only are they a good group, but they're a great bunch of guys. You really are.
Well, thank you,
but
Mike.
We've worked together on some fair dates and things, and on fairs, you know how they stick you in trailers? They give everybody a trailer to dress in. I went in their trailer between the shows. And
$2 limit, Mike.
$2 limit. It was fun to watch, though. Tell us about this new album. I know you're excited about it.
Well, this is our latest album.
I'm out for Smokey Robinson and the Miracles,
and it just came out yesterday. And in this album is included our two latest singles. This is a first for us.
And Martin and John is doing fabulous.
Yes, and we're very happy about that. It's a first for us in the record business, in as much as we do have two singles out at the same time.
Both on the charts.
Right, we're very happy about that. Plus it has a few of the other tunes that have been made popular by other artists, such as Wichita Lineman.
Yeah.
And
For Once in My Life.
Yeah, For Once in My Life, My Girl.
I Heard Is Over. Hey, you're involved in something brand new. I want you to tell about that.
Well, what's happening is Berry Gordy, who is the president of Motown Records, is now living in Los Angeles because we're going more into the movie and television production, which we hope to get started very soon. We're just laying the foundations for the work at the present time.
Mm-hmm. There would be all black people involved in these movies and
well, no, not necessarily. No. We're open-minded.
I know everybody thinks that Motown is that way, and that's not true.
No, that's not true at all. We're a very integrated organization.
Our musical director, Joe Harnell, just signed with Motown. Did you know that?
Yes, I did, and we're very happy to
do
have
you. Do they need any lady singers?
Like
a lady. I talked to Maurice, you know,
right,
a couple
Maurice
times.
King.
Maurice, yeah, King.
Yeah.
And I said, hey, Maurice, you want a nice lady who likes to sing? And the next thing I knew, I did a special with the Temptations. And
yeah,
we have an
sad.
Album that's released with
right.
me and the Temptations and George Kirby.
Yeah, you were great.
I'm so
great.
Thrilled.
Yeah.
Gee, who do you know at Motown? I can talk to somebody.
Oh.
Don't know anybody if you know him.
Welcome.
You're talking to the Veep right now. You're the vice president up there, aren't you?
Great.
Yes, I am one of the vice presidents.
Are you really?
Yes, I am.
Oh, hi.
Hi.
Mama.
You're hired. Smokey, you have a new addition to your family, boy or girl?
It's a boy, and I'm very happy about that.
What's his name?
Is Barry William Barope Robinson.
Barope?
Barope.
Yes.
How do you spell that?
It's B-O-R-O-P-E, which are the first two initials of the guy's names that I sing with, Bobby, Ronnie, and Pete. And
hey, that's wild.
Barry is from Barry Gordy, who is my greatest friend, and he's a wonderful guy. So I named him after the guys that I love the most.
Hey, that's nice. That's really nice. I wonder what he's going to say later in life when he says, Dad, where did I get that middle name, Barope?
Well, he'll have to beat up his uncles.
Well, let's meet the members of the group responsible for that name, shall we?
Sure.
Okay.
Wonderful.
Come on out a minute. These are the miracles, everyone. Miracles. I don't know if you can. Can you hear me? I want to get up here if I may, because I want to.
Want me to help you, Mike?
No, I'm fine.
Come on. Take it easy.
Ronnie, I don't know how to bring this up, but I did notice a change in you, and I understand you want to talk about it. I think it's wonderful that you do.
Yeah.
What's something with.
What happens is I have Bell's palsy. It's a virus that's settled around the nerve, the facial nerve, and it's disconnected the nerve.
And just nothing is working there
right.
at the moment, huh?
It's really weird. There's no pain or anything involved.
Yeah. Will it come back?
Yeah, it's coming back now.
Oh, that's marvelous.
You're doing physical therapy and taking some medication.
Mm-hmm.
And
I'm trying to get it to go on the other side.
You guys are a big help. But that must be a frightening thing when you wake up in the morning and find yourself like that. You know?
At first it was, until I found out exactly what it was.
Mm-hmm.
But that's fine.
Mm-hmm.
I'm happy that it's going away finally.
Well, that doesn't hurt your singing or performing in any way. So do people ask you about it?
Yeah, just the P's and the S.
A little bit of trouble.
Right.
Well, we're delighted to have you back with us, guys, always.
It's really wonderful being back, Mike.
Thank you. And we want you to sing another song for us. Is this a new one from the album also?
Yes, it is.
Yes.
Abraham, Martin, and John.
Abraham, Martin, and John. It's a big single, too. Smokey Robinson and the Miracles.
Everybody here see my old friend Abraham. Can you tell me where he's gone? Are he free? A lot of people, but the good. Try to find some good ideas for you. Oh, yeah.
started walking way over the hill. They were parking down. They were parking down.
Yeah. other man's grass is always greener. Some are lucky, some are not. Just be thankful for the grass you've got.
Sure is mellow grazing in the grass.
Grazing in the grass is a gas, baby, can you dig?
What a trip, what a trip. Just watching as the world goes past.